100.
So we're going to start out with
we can use yours because you don't have a Mac.
Huh?
We can use your laptop because the board is different for a MacBook.
It says HDMI.
So we can just use yours. Just bring yours.
Bring mine?
Yeah, because okay. We all have Macs.
So we're just going to start out with Mac.
Kevin, I don't think he has one.
Just so everybody knows where Honda is.
Oh, yeah. I don't want to.
The next slide, we'll talk about
the
third segment. Yeah, so this is the sales trend. We based it off of silent revenue. We were going to do vehicles earlier, but we decided to go with revenue because it's just where everybody spread out. So we went by revenue. We decided to use each, it was pretty meticulous process. We looked at all their 10-Ks. One thing that we realized was that Honda and Nissan, they reported their stuff in yen, and Hyundai reported it in won. So we had to take all the information and we had to convert it so that it, you can easily see where everything's at. So when we did that, we kind of just made our own instead of finding one. We used Excel to make this graph. And as you can see, GM is obviously a lot larger than everyone else. But if you look at Hyundai, you can see they're growing consistently, very close to Honda. In 2016, the last one, they're only, you know, they're a little bit behind the Honda. They're growing very fast. As from the Reuters website, they were ranked the fastest growing automobile industry, growing at 3.1% faster than everyone else. So if you look at the next slide, this is just their segments, so Honda, Hyundai, Nissan. So this is more in depth. It'll show you the sales trend, and you know, you can see Hyundai and Honda right there next to each other. Now that you guys have an idea where Honda is relative to everyone else, we're going to talk a little bit about the industry lifecycle. So we all know like what the industry lifecycle is. This is just a section of it. This is the mature stage. Even though all three of these companies are in the mature stage, we think they're in different sections of the mature stage. Hyundai is a lot closer, earlier part of the mature stage. So they're doing a lot more different things because they're early enough to do that. Honda's right in the middle. They do have a pretty strong position. They're just using incremental innovation. They're changing small things. Keeping customers interested. They're not trying to confuse their customers. So they have a position, they're kind of just holding it. Ford is the furthest in the mature stage. They've been a lot out for a lot longer. And again, just incremental innovation. So that pretty much covers where they are in the industry lifecycle, and we're gonna talk about some generic competitive strategies.
So about the general competitive strategy, we believe that Honda used both thought leadership and differentiation as a general competitive strategy to gain competitive advantage over its competitor. So at first, Honda and its competitor used thought leadership to gain competitive advantage, but right now everyone is using cost leadership, so it's not enough to get orders in the product. So Honda is now switching to more differentiation in its strategy. And so currently Honda offers a wide range of products at low cost, but it's also add more features to meet the customer demand. And it's still offering the high quality efficiency vehicles. So look at some model in 2016. Compare Honda Civic with Hyundai Elantra, Ford Focus, and Nissan Sentra. Honda Civic has much more feature in like driver and safety assist and audio features. So we believe that Honda is now in like more differentiation in this strategy. So when we apply the 5 of model to a Honda, so we believe that the rivalry is very high because the competition in the auto industry is high because there are many firms in the industry trying to compete each other to get more profit than others. And for Honda, We listen for our main competitor in the strategy group, and so Honda has to keep innovating and improving to stay effective in the industry. The threat of substitute, we think that it's not a huge threat of substitute because even though they are public transportation like drones and buses, but and people can buy a motorbike or bicycle, but they are not as convenient as automobiles. So, and also, there are huge capital requirements too, and a strong distribution network to replace automobiles. So, for the threat of new entrants, we believe that it's kind of low because Honda, Hyundai, Ford, and Nissan already in the motor stage, and it's so hard for new entrants to enter the market to compete with them. And these companies are trying to protect themselves by setting new many barriers to keep new entrants from getting into the market. And also, it's very risky to enter into the automobile industry because it requires huge capital investment, and the successful rate is very low. So for the buyer profit power, we think that it's moderate because there are many folks in the automobile industry and they are offering many wide range of product and customers. Not when customers decide to buy a car, they look at the quality price design from different brands. And moreover, first customer wants something new and nice looking with the latest technology. So firms like Honda has to make its car become unique and attractive to customers. It's not easy for them to charge premium price. So we think that buyer volume power is moderate. And the last one is buyer volume power. We think that they are, like, each firm in the automobile industry has thousands of suppliers, and they only rely on like couple major suppliers. So even though the supplier profit power is significant, it's kind of limited because if they increase the cost higher, firms can switch to new supplier, and supplier hold very little power in profit power.
So for the marketing strategies, the target market for Honda is basically anyone with a driver's license, anyone who's looking for a vehicle. Honda has a diversified range of products, ranging from big to small, compact to full-size vans, like the Honda Odyssey, common luxuries that caters to all sorts of customers, and basically anyone can come to Honda and buy a vehicle that suits their needs. Honda promotes its products well in the market and has adopted a sound and effective policy for the supply of their vehicles, and Honda fully understands what the market demands by providing such products that are a good fit for each market segment. The success in these strategies leads to their strong brand loyalty.
So now I'm going to talk about the competitive effect of national model. When we do the reset, we do the reset on a national level. So I think I know the definition of competitive advantage of nation models, meaning in that company, in different countries, have their own competitive advantage, not only to satisfy customers' expectations, but also to compete with other companies in local market. So even if they are the same automobile brand, the same specification of car are still different in different countries, automobile industry. For example, we can compare the government regulation and product innovation in different automobile industries. So for product innovation in US, the automaker focus more about customer design like comfort, speed, and safety. So they decide to develop the road drivetrain or the bus suspension and interior. So for example, in Europe, the automaker focus more on the performance and agility feature of the vehicle. So they decide the steel belt, radial tire, fuel injection, and even the turbo diesel engine. And for the German auto industry, the car specification due to the carbon and the scarcity of fuel material and space. So in terms of government regulation, So even US, European, and Japan, they focus on safety, like CO2 emission and the fuel economy. So hopefully in the future, it's based on the US auto motor revolution. So hopefully in the future, in 2025, it's a lot carbon emission that can look for the fuel economy and they can have the CO2 emission. So besides those, there are some competitive aspects of US automobile industry. They have strong domestic rival, having strong supplier, and also they have huge number of customers. So because all of that, the US automobile industry, they are in the world's second largest market. So move on to strategic group analysis. So we consider Honda, Nissan, and Ford as Honda strategic group because they have a similar strategic segment set at the lower cost structure, which is high product market scope, low price, and high quality.
Technology, they move forward to higher technology, and they spend a lot.